1.6 million. That's the number of people killed by fungal infections worldwide in a single year. In 2021, at least 7,000 of those deaths were in the US. That's more than 15 times as many as in 1969. We're not speeding towards a Last of Us fungal apocalypse. But health experts are worried about the growing number of severe fungal infections, the kind that infect the blood and attack the lungs and the brain. Let's go over three main reasons why fungi are becoming more of a threat and why it could get even worse. Climate change may be having an impact on fungal evolution. This map from 2017 shows the states that reported cases of Candida auris, an often deadly fungus. Fast forward a few years. Not only has Candida auris spread beyond a handful of states, but as you can see, the case count has also skyrocketed. The spread to more places is also happening with other severe fungal infections, like histoplasmosis and valley fever.
Their range has really exploded over the last, like, 50 years or so.
Fungi, whether it's ones you eat like these, or the ones that make you sick when you breathe their spores in, they like temperatures that are warm, but not too hot. So as the planet warms, places that were too cold before are becoming more fungi-friendly. They may also be adapting to be more tolerant of high heat, and that includes the human body.
Possibly because they've adapted to warmer temperatures, it seems like they've become better at infecting us.
Some recent evidence for that comes from this study that Dominique told me about. In a lab, scientists grew hundreds of generations of a fungus called Cryptococcus deneiformans. Some were grown at 98.6 degrees Fahrenheit, others at 86 degrees.
It seemed that heat and hotter temperatures was really triggering them to mutate more.
The fungi were adapting. Scientists haven't documented this kind of heat-driven evolution in the wild yet, but that may be because this area of research is just so new. For most of human existence, we've coexisted peacefully with fungi.
It seems like they might help us digest food, maybe even fight disease. Fungi are all around us. They help connect our forests. They break down our dead things. Like, they're just so critical to life.
It's only recently that they've become more worrisome pathogens. Ironically, one reason for this shift is modern medicine. Better treatments for a range of diseases has made it possible for people to live longer, even when their immune systems aren't working optimally. Infectious fungi are particularly dangerous for people with compromised immune systems. Like patients who are going through cancer treatment, have advanced HIV infections, or are taking high doses of steroids. By some estimates, almost 3% of the US population is immunocompromised. And this population is expected to grow. Adding to the problem is that we don't have a lot of options for treating severe fungal infections. It's hard to develop treatments that kill fungi without also being toxic to humans, even at low doses. That's because fungal cells are similar to human ones.
The fungi that are currently causing disease have developed resistance to a lot of these known antifungals.
This new study showed there were three times as many resistant Candida auris infections in 2021 as in each of the previous 2 years. The pipeline for new drugs is also limited because of a lack of investment. But that's starting to change.
So I think there has been more interest from pharmaceutical companies, from researchers, to really look at this as a potential area of R&D, but it's still kind of burgeoning.
And there are drugs in clinical trials from several companies. It's important to remember that even though the threat from fungi is growing, dying from a fungal infection is still pretty rare. This study estimated that in 2019, 7.7 million people died globally from infections caused by bacteria like E. coli and Staph aureus. That's almost 5 times as many as have died because of a fungus. And on a lighter note, if you're still scared that a fungus that looks like this can turn you and your friends into zombies,
there's no indication that that's gonna happen, at least not anytime in the next few million years. You know, fungi have to really evolve to be able to do that.
Whew, that's a relief.